on his way back to Britain. He called Captain Alfredo at Steve's, and he's been held as a prisoner of war on Ascension Island. But he doesn't know, so there's no convenient place to keep him there. So he's been shipped to this country, still as a prisoner of war. Now, 10 days ago, these 200 of his fellow prisoners were sent back to Argentina, where heroes welcome. But Captain Alfredo was kept in detention after Sweden and France had asked to interview him over torture allegations. Nearly a month ago, the Captain Alfredo signed a document of surrender on HMS Plymouth, and he was the chap who was entertained at dinner in the wardroom by British officers. But then ugly rumours about his past began to circulate. Captain Death and the Blonde Angel were his nicknames in Argentina, according to dissidents there. He was alleged to have tortured and killed perhaps hundreds of opponents of the military regime in Buenos Aires. Dagmar Hagelin, a Swedish girl of 17, was shot there 5 years ago when she went to visit a friend whose husband had just been arrested. And two French nuns, Sister Alice and Sister Rene, were tortured the following year for harbouring dissidents when they mysteriously disappeared. Now, although Sweden and France want to question Captain Alfredo about those incidents, he is protected by the Geneva Convention, because as a prisoner of war, the only information he's obliged to give is his name, his rank, and his number. But he can help him as long as possible to survive. At the same time, the Foreign Office is very well aware that three British journalists, Simon Winchester, Toby Fry, and Ian Mather, are still being held on spying charges in the Argentinian jail. So far, attempts to get them free have been unsuccessful. In the 6 years since this military took over in Argentina, torture and repression have become rife. According to Amnesty International, 6,800 people are reported as having disappeared. For the local human rights groups, put the true figure at near 15,000. And there are many, like Anna McHugh, the Argentinian wife of a school teacher from Manchester, who have grisly tales to tell.
All the girls have been tortured. I've seen Marcel Hildegard burned. The picana, when someone has been tortured with a picana, there is a mark in the skin. And some of them have been raped several times. And when I was there one night, one girl came, one blonde girl, and she was unconscious for several hours. And when she came round, she said that she had been tortured. And they were going to torture her again till she told them what her
boyfriend was. Well, 4 years since then, the court of Strasbourg has continued to offer the one conservative member of parliament who writes that there's evidence to suggest that Captain Alfredo has been involved in the torture of British citizens in Argentina. What are these British nationals going to write? What do you know about them?
There are allegations have been made, that I received last week from a very good and reliable that at least several British nationals had been interrogated, tortured, and then imprisoned in Argentina by these secret police squads. And also, it may have been that Captain Alfredo had been involved in several cases, and I'm now awaiting the evidence. It's on its way to Montevideo.
So you're sure of your evidence, are you?
Well, insofar as one can be, but communication is very, very difficult and often directed to teams. And therefore I'm waiting for more material. So it has to be upside that these are allegations only at the
state. Now tell me, why is Alfredo being brought back here?
That's the question you have to put to the government, because when you heard this afternoon, I imagine that it's within the Geneva Convention, the rules and regulations of a country which is in hostility to a war with another, can in fact bring the prisoner back to home base.
So in other words, we would have to return him, would you not, under the Geneva Convention?
That, I think, several lawyers have to argue. I decide to argue. I can't comment on that.
The sort of things that we are talking about and have been alleged against him, are those the sort of things that part of the reason you're fighting with war, the sort of the way that the Argentinians conduct their affairs?
Well, it's not directly connected with their aggression on the Falkland Islands, although it's an ominous sign of what might happen if they were allowed to stay there, and it's now because political regime on the island. That's the purpose of the task force.
The complication of our three journalists there must be a worrying one.
I think it is, and the other worry, you see, is an expression about, now, when I get this evidence, which I hope is going to come in a day or two now, and revealing names, I think there's at least one girl involved, maybe in prison for years and years, by the way things are going. Do I reveal the names? Because what happens to the friends, relations, and parents, and so on, if they're also in Buenos Aires or in Argentina?
It's said that this man is young, good-looking, very difficult to believe that he could be capable of such a venture property. You convince him?
I think the main thing with that is, and that's why I spoke out last week in a preliminary way when I heard the delegation for the first time, the main thing is that we need time to look into them most carefully, to do justice to the whole situation, and do justice to him. But the allegations are very clear, and they've been made repeatedly from a number of years.
Let me take my trousers off. Don't be in such a hurry. Let me take my chance, sir. Tell me what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you the biggest screw of your life before I'm going to die.
I am an American citizen. My name is John. I am an American citizen. My name is John. I am an American citizen. My name is John.
I had a very nice time.
I am an American citizen.
May I call on you again? Please speak more slowly. I do not understand. Do you understand me? I do not think so. Repeat it, please. What am I to do?
I
recall a police officer,
an American citizen. My name is John.
How much must I pay? Ticket to Hamburg with running water.
I am an American citizen.
Toilet paper.
My name is John.
I would like to speak to the manager.
I am an American citizen.
Is the tip included? I want to go shopping. I have a brassiere.
I am an American citizen. My name is John.
May I take a snapshot of you?
I am American citizen.
A wild west.
My name is Brown.
Sanitary napkin. May I change this for a second?
A wild west. My name is Brown. My name is John. I am the American citizen. I am the American citizen.
I had a very nice time.
My name is John. Take your
hand. May I call on you again? Please speak more slowly.
My name is John.
I changed this for a salad.
I am an American citizen.
I do not understand.
My name is John.
Do you understand me? Repeat it, please.
My name is John.
What am I to do?
I am an American
citizen. I will try to
please you. My name is John.
The American consulate.
My name is John.
All this is for my personal use.
I am an American citizen again.
Please speak.
My name is John.
How much must I pay?
My name is John.
How much is a round trip ticket to Hamburg with running
water? I am an American citizen.
What am I to
toilet paper? My name is John.
I would like to speak to the manager.
I am an American citizen.
Is the
tip? My name is John.
I want to go shopping.
I am an American citizen. My name is John.
Shopping.
A brand. I am an American citizen. My name is John.
I am an American citizen.